Mission board. Self-service bounty clearance.
Consider another Star Saptor. Tell your friends.
Bye. We will. Thanks again.
No problem.
Excuse me, Bill. You've got to do a better job of keeping your tour groups out of trouble.
Star Sap?
What do you mean?
That little boy almost wound up on my operating table. Claudio said he was playing with some of the machinery down by the mines and nearly got his arm stuck inside. It could have been ripped off.
Oh, I'm sorry. You know, kids, little troublemakers. I'll tell the guests to be more careful.
Damn right. You've got to do something. Or else next time it happens, I'm billing you personally.
Oh, boy.
Yeesh.
Great. Another tourist. Let me guess. You slipped on the ice and need a doctor to wrap your sprained ankle?
No. I have a pimple. No. What's your problem with tourists? Don't they help the local economy?
They do, but they're also a terrible burden for a small colony doctor like myself. I have enough trouble treating our own people with the time and resources I have.
No. I'm here visiting, but I'm not a tourist.
I appreciate that you're trying to set me at ease, but that might as well be the same.
Yeah, whatever.
Sorry for how I responded. It's not you, it's me. I'm just frustrated about all the non-native people I need to treat when our own still need help. Anyway, what can I do for you?
I'm looking for some surgery. No, just kidding. Speak with Giuliana, okay. Are there any dangerous hazards to worry about on Titan? I mean, freezing cold, I guess, but anything else?
It's a harsh world, but as long as you're inside or wear a suit when going out, you'll be fine here. There's no breathable air on the surface, and you'll quickly freeze to death outside without protective gear, but otherwise, the hazards are minimal.
Otherwise.
New Homestead was an early colony research base and has stood the test of time. It's safe, and it's proof that people can live pretty much anywhere. Don't worry so much.
I thought you want everyone to be very careful because you don't have enough resources to help everyone at the same time. Is it difficult being a doctor in such an old-fashioned community like this?
Even though we don't have shiny new medical facilities, I imagine it's easier than wherever you're from. We have fewer people here, and we're very responsible when it comes to our personal health and welfare. So there's not much I can't handle.
That doesn't track.
For anything else, we can get access to off-world specialists. Contrary to popular belief, we're not primitive.
All of a sudden, it's not a problem.
Everything okay?
No. I'm deceased. Okay. Medical supplies, I guess.
Of course. Just the basics here, but I'm sure you'll find what you need.
Let's just take a bunch of these things. For the most part, I have like one of each, so... I'll skip that. I'll take all these med packs. That was expensive, huh? Penicillin. Snake oil. Zipper bandages. Okay. I already have at least one thing that gets rid of all addictions. And I've had it for quite a while. Who knows when I'll have to use it, but... Alright, thanks.
Try to be careful out there.
Mm-hmm. Maurice?
There are times I envy those who are able to travel like you.
Are you?
Hello there. Are you here to peruse our little museum exhibit?
Oh. They won't even turn around and look at us. Okay, that's a little better. Run on cue, too. Not yet, but I was planning on it.
Please do. Our collection of unique Earth antiquities is the best in the settled systems, if I say so myself.
A VHS tape.
If you have any questions about the exhibit or New Homestead, I'm happy to answer as best as I can.
Who are you and what do you do around here?
I am Maurice Lyon, and I am the community elder. As the oldest living citizen at 96, my only job is to keep Earth history alive. I tell stories to the young people and the visitors from other worlds. Although my memory isn't what it used to be, I try my best to get the stories right.
Okay. Everyone here has such interesting family names. What's the deal with that?
When our early colonists learned of Earth's demise, they decided to take on the names of their cities of origin as a way to remember their heritage. Hmm. Now, some may have been lost in translation over the years, and some may have taken it more seriously than others, but the names are mostly accurate.
I hadn't noticed.
For instance, my family comes from the city of Lyon, in a country that was called France.
France is gone. Can you tell me about how New Homestead came to be?
It's an interesting story. New Homestead began as a scientific research base called the Titan Astro Base, back when space travel was in its infancy. The hope was that humanity would be able to discover simple alien life here, given the moon's composition and water supply. When that ultimately failed, it was repurposed as a colony research base, where scientists and engineers studied how to build colonies on inhospitable worlds. Then, finally, when gravity drives were commonplace and we started finding Earth-like planets, New Homestead was born as a living history community to preserve that past.
Okay.
Sorry, were you saying something?
No, you were saying something. Could you tell me a story about Earth?
Sure, I'd love to.
The writer won't turn around.
There was once a war, so big that they say all of the world was involved. This was actually the second time it happened.
Oh yeah, in 1940s,
they fought because a terrible man named Hitler rose to power and slaughtered many innocents. Millions were lost. Even the colony war pales in comparison.
Really? Have any more Earth stories?
Why, certainly. It's what I do.
Tell Earth stories.
There was a time when huge monstrosities called dinosaurs ruled over Earth, long before humans existed. They were similar to some of the larger life forms you might see elsewhere in the settled systems.
Hmm.
Their reign ended when I can never remember if it was a comet, an asteroid, or a meteor that hit the Earth.
A meteor.
Whatever it was, it nearly wiped out most of the life at that time.
Have time to tell another story?
Let me think of a good one. A long time ago, thousands of years, humans built a wall so large it spanned the northern length of one of Earth's largest empires, China. They called it the Great Wall of China, and it was meant to keep out invading hordes. If I recall correctly, it didn't always work as well as they had hoped.
Oh, really?
I'll have to look it up again. Memory's not what it once was.
Okay. Can you tell me more about the exhibit?
Of course. Certainly. We have several items in our collection that we rotate in and out over time, but they all originate from the same place. Earth. We have everything from toys to antique technology to sports memorabilia. We even used to have an old Earth vehicle, but we had to sell it when we ran out of space for it.
Hmm.
Most of our collection was donated by fellow Earth enthusiasts and historians who felt it belonged close to the homeland here in the Sol system.
All right, well, thanks. It was great looking at the back of your head.
Take care.
Oh, we can't get the description? It looked like you would, like, well, this is big for a button, but you'd press it and be like, this is a VHS tape. Is that like a Sony Discman or something? Hey, hey. I wonder which computer this actually is, because an Apple II, maybe? Apple IIe? Oh, to tell us, right? A range of antique Earth computers ranging from the late 1980s to the mid-2000s. Computers have existed in some form since Charles Babbage's Difference Engine in 1822. The years from the mid-20th century into the early 21st century were known for some of the greatest advances in computing technology, as computers shrank from gigantic or gigantic room-sized devices filled with vacuum tubes to small boxes filled with microprocessors like the one you see here. That's too bad. It doesn't say what kind it is. It looks like an Apple IIe. Maybe. Not sure. I never had an Apple II.
Lay eyes on the earth just once.
Just once. Antique Earth Media. Assorted Earth Media. Clockwise from bottom left, book, Tales of from Space and Time, H.G. Wells, 1899. Book on the Origin of Species, Charles Darwin, 1859. Book, Frankenstein, Mary Shelley, 1818. Portable Compact Disc Player, 1993. Book, Sailing Alone Around the World, Joshua Slocum, 1900. And videotape, 1976. Cool. I'm not sure what kind of instrument that is. Antique instrument of unknown origin, Earth. Believed to be of West African origin, possibly a type of ngoni, a harp-like string instrument traditionally used in ceremonies accompanied with chanting and storytelling. This instrument was generously donated to the New Homestead Museum, but its true origin is unfortunately lost to time.
Hello there. The museum here is free to everyone.
Yes, and we're... He's old. He forgot he just talked to us. Alright, so we're out here. A baseball. Holographs of some kind of columns. And a lake. Stuff. Alright. Soccer ball. Basketball. Various Earth sports photos and memorabilia. From left to right. Championship baseball, Boston, Massachusetts, 1978. Game-winning soccer ball, International League, 2018. Basketball used by the United States World Champion Basketball Team, 1992. And record-setting home run baseball, 1935. We've got a piggy bank and a wooden duck. Earth animals. Commercial reproductions of Earth fauna. Throughout human history, replicas of Earth animals were used in many different ways, from toys and games to more practical uses such as these items. Piggy bank, left, as far back as the 15th century hollowed-out ceramic statue of the animal known as Peak were properly used to store physical currency. Well, that's one way of putting it. Decoy duck, right? Waterfowl known as ducks were once hunted near Earth's... Do we still have ducks? Well, they mean were because we don't hunt them. Were once hunted near Earth's marshes for sport and food using ballistic rifles. To facilitate this activity, hunters would often place wooden decoy ducks in the water and use a small woodwind instrument to produce an accompanying call resembling that of the duck in order to lure it in. Yeah, brilliant. Outwitting simple animals. Not impressive.
We take vandalism seriously here. You don't mess with history.
But are you on the right side of history? Okay, so there's a hockey stick. Championship ice hockey stick. Ice hockey stick used on Earth in the city of Edmonton, Canada during a 1988 championship game. Ice hockey is a contact sport played on an ice rink where two teams with five players and two goaltenders called goalies compete to deposit a rubberized puck in the other team's goal. The players traverse the rink on specialized shoes mounted on thin metal blades called ice skates and manipulate the puck with specialized curved sticks such as the one displayed here. And then here we've got... I'm not sure what that's supposed to be. Is it a water bladder or something? Some wires. Okay, a compass. And a telescope?
Enjoy your visit here.
Thank you. Go away. Miscellaneous Earth knickknacks. From left to right, unknown decorative liquor bottle brought from Earth to New Homestead during its original mission. Okay, so liquor bottle. Electronic pipes used to inhale various legal substances during early New Homestead colonial times. Oh, sure, illegal. Equinoctial dial brought to New Homestead by one of the original settlers as a family heirloom. Original construction, 1800. Or estimated 1800. Scroll case. Oh, it's a scroll case of unknown date. It's smaller. I started thinking this was the Elder Scroll in here, but that looks smaller. It looks small, right? Believed to have once been a sacred relic, this old scroll case likely predates any other synthetic item in the museum. The scroll itself has been lost to time. I mean, it looks like a smaller version of the case for the Elder Scroll. Oh, he's got that book. I'm going to talk to this guy. Don't worry about it.
Did you know the museum here is full of old Earth artifacts? Cool, huh?
Yeah, look at some kind of rocks. Meteorites. Natural space debris like asteroids and meteoroids routinely enter planetary or moon atmospheres to impact the surface below. When a meteor survives its journey through the atmosphere and makes impact, the result is a meteorite such as the one seen in these display cases. Displayed to the left, a polished and rounded piece of the Gibeon meteorite, which impacted Earth 600 million years ago. What's that one? And displayed ahead from left to right. There's only one. Left to right. There's another piece. Carbonaceous chondrite meteorite, which impacted Titan about 250 million years ago. Piece of the Dronino meteorite, which is believed to have impacted Earth more than 1,200 years ago. Oh, so maybe that. It's these three things. Wait. Oh, polished and rounded piece of the Gibeon meteorite is this. And the other two are those. Okay. A NASA snow globe or moon globe? Lunar lander, space shuttle. Some more landers, some more shuttles. All right, let's see. Let's have them in the shot so we can see. NASA, one of several Earth-based space agencies, was instrumental in humankind's earliest journeys into space. Indeed, it was due to the efforts of NASA that New Homestead exists. In 2107, NASA sent an unmanned probe to Titan, which paved the way for the development of the Titan Astrobase, completed in 2130. By 2185, the Titan Astrobase project was transitioned into the colony of New Homestead. From left to right, NASA prototype rocket, NASA branded mug. Oh yeah, those two things. Vostok 1, USSR space program, space shuttle Discovery, Apollo 11, and collectible snow globes. Items on loan from NASA. Which ones are on loan? Because I don't see a star. There's more stuff over here. Some kind of cafeteria. Hi.
Hello.
Facilities, storage, clinic, and exit. Alright, so I got this thing over here. Meteorites. Natural space debris like asteroids and meteoroids routinely... This is the same thing. Left to right. Is it? Okay. I'm not sure, that's different. Routinely enters planetary and moon atmospheres to impact the surface below. When a meteor survives its journey through the atmosphere and makes impact, the result is a meteorite such as the one seen in this display case. Left to right, unaltered piece of the Gibeon meteorite, which impacted Earth about 600 million years ago. Fluorescent meteorite, which impacted Titan about 20 million years ago. And slab of the Nantan meteorite, which believed to have impacted Earth about 800 years ago. Running around for.
Word of advice, steer clear of the doctor here. She really seems to have a problem with tourists for some reason.
Oh, she's alright. Oh, cool. We got model ships here. RV Calypso. Scale model of the RV Calypso. Originally commissioned by the British Royal Navy as a minesweeper vessel and launched in 1942, it was later repurposed by famed Earth oceanographic researcher? Is that how you say that? Oceanographic? I think it's oceanographic. I mean, it sounds stupid otherwise. Jacques Cousteau in 1950. Cousteau dedicated his life to exploring Earth's oceans further and deeper than anyone before him. During his expeditions, he formed a deeper understanding of the sea's fragile ecosystems and became an advocate for ocean preservation. Jay? I'm being you. He's another ship. HMS Beagle. Scale model of the HMS Beagle. Originally constructed for the British Navy as a war vessel and first launched in 1820, this Cherokee-class brig sloop was most famous for transporting renowned scientist Charles Darwin during his famous worldwide research voyage in 1831 to 1836. These things light up. Like you can take them. Alright.
We live a simple life on New Homestead. But make no mistake, it's fulfilling.
Maurice Lyon's journal. Scanning Earth was astonishing. There's just nothing. The whole planet is covered with sand and will never support life again. Really. I did scan after scan of the major population centers and returned nothing. I did get a glimmer on the ancient site of Hong Kong. It was faint. I wasn't sure, I just imagined it, but I landed there. And there, amidst the unrecognizable sands, was something. What was this edifice? This monument of a now-dead civilization. It was humbling and deeply depressing. Excerpts from Maurice Lyon's journal. That's a mission. Visit the Hong Kong landmark on Earth. Okay. Sounds like a plan.
I could really go for some of Anya's cooking over at the Brown Horse.
The Brown Horse? For sure, rough draft. Star Sap Tours. Visit historical New Homestead and take a comprehensive, genuine Star Sap tour. Learn about the early days of humanity's ventures into space. See how people lived in the colonies of yore. Speak and interact with traditional Titan citizens experiencing early colony life. Explore the frozen surface of Titan.
New Homestead's quite the learning experience. Bring your kids! Why, hello there! I'm Bill Starsap of Starsap Tours. Let me tell you, this place is full of history and interesting facts.
Oh yeah?
For instance, did you know that New Homestead was one of the first colonies established outside of Earth?
Yes.
It's been populated in some capacity for over 200 years.
Of course. Everyone knows that. You know, I would if I had a stupid name like Starsap, because that's his last name. Everyone knows that guy.
I knew you were a fellow history buff. Well, tell you what. You come along on one of my little tours, and I guarantee you'll learn something you didn't know before. So what do you say? I've got an opening. I could take you on a tour right now if you'd like.
What do you recommend seeing while I'm here? Anything to avoid?
Definitely check out the Brown Horse Tavern. Good food, great atmosphere. Avoid spending too much time outdoors. It's freezing out there. Any more than that, well, I'd be giving away the tour for free.
No offense, but Starsap is an unusual name. Sounds almost, like, made up. Oh, they named themselves after the cities they came from. Was this a city called Starsap?
None taken. I get it all the time. If you think it sounds made up, well, that's because it is. I come from an eccentric family. Back in the early days of space travel, generations ago, my ancestors were really into science fiction. They wanted a name that seemed like it fit into the stories they grew up with, so they changed their last name, and the Starsap family name was born. Used to be Bramblefoot before that. Their ancestors liked a different type of fiction.
Okay.
Make fun of us for a period of time of your choosing.
Why? Need some more time to think about it?
Absolutely. Why would someone want a tour of New Homestead?
Why would I want a tour of New Homestead, she says? Well, let me tell you. New Homestead is living history. These people are direct descendants of some of the first settlers to leave Earth. If you've ever wanted to know what that early colonial life was like, this is your chance to embark on a fun-filled exhibition unlike any other.
Wow, okay. All right, sure, I'd like to go on the tour then.
Excellent! Excellent! You won't regret it! My tours are one of a kind! Now, there's just the matter of price. The going rate for a genuine Star Sap tour is only 100 credits.
Sure.
Great! Let's get this show on the road, eh?